Political issues take up so much of the conversational space that it's easy for people to forget that these are ephemeral and fleeting concepts in juxtaposition and collocation and contrast against its dichotomy, its antipode, and that is the philosophical or metaphysical or epistemological issues of value theory and aesthetics and ethics and metaphysics, etc. These are the issues that are so much larger, that are so much more perennial, that are so much less ephemeral, and those are the things that interest me. That being said, there are two political issues that I would give my life for, that I want to stand up for, and this is what we need to vote in. We need to do whatever it takes to protect the environment, to protect the habitat of the animals, to do whatever it takes to protect this planet in order that the animals may live safely, freely, happily, fully, and truly flourish, and do whatever it takes to do so, and to get officers, political officials in power who will make sure that that happens, ensure that. So that being said, like, those are the two that really matter to me. And yet people say, well, how do we make like socialism work on a 400 million, you know, person scale when it comes to, you know, blowing it up, scaling it up to America, where you have 400 million people as contrasted against, you know, small European countries where it works, etc. Or how to make the medical, the healthcare system really successful, or whatever the issues are. I understand that these truly matter to people, but I will say what truly matters to me on a genuine, deep, visceral, atomic, molecular level, it like burns in my bones, is do whatever it takes to protect the habitat of the animals, because this is their world. We live in it, so we need to protect their habitat. We need to protect the animals. That is huge. That is massive. Like, I was watching videos of a silverback gorilla, and I'm just like, these are kings among us. They're beyond royalty. I mean, that's like an insult to call them kings. And yet when you call somebody a gorilla, that's an insult to humans in today's jargon and parlance, when it should be the other way around. It's like the biggest compliment ever. And so the fact of the matter is, like, you know how pigs have like the intelligence of a small child? And yet, like, I think the two great crimes in American history is the second greatest crime is slavery, and the first greatest crime is the genocide that is committed against animals. You say, well, why isn't it flip-flop? Because imagine, if a corrupt human enslaves another corrupt human, that's a terrible thing. But if a corrupt human slaughters and tortures a toddler, that's an even worse crime. And yet the toddler is the intelligence, has the sociability, has the identity that a pig does, or a chimpanzee does, or elephant, dolphins, etc., cats, dogs, etc. So it's the greatest crime in American history is the genocide that's committed against animals, and in world history as well, and we need to change it. So in this political season, we need to do whatever it takes to protect the animals and to save their habitat.